let's explore the Zoom Phone user interface in the desktop application. While I am using a Mac for this demonstration, the user interface will look nearly identical on Windows. In the Zoom application, click on Phone along the top navigation. If the phone icon isn't shown, it means your account administrator hasn't assigned Zoom Phone to you. There are two distinct sections to Zoom Phone. The primary dial pad section transforms when texting or in an active call, and the sidebar organizes information into four subsections. First, let's cover how to make a call. Here, you can manually enter the phone number you wish to call. If enabled by an administrator, you can also change your caller ID or even hide your caller ID. If you don't know the number for whom you wish to reach, you can enter the name of the person you wish to call and Zoom will search your list of contacts. Click on a contact to initiate a call or hover over the caret to see any other numbers associated with that contact. Along the top left, you will see subsections for Zoom Phone, which are History, Voicemail, Lines, and SMS. Switching between these sections changes the information displayed beneath them. Again, if you don't see a feature such as SMS, that's because your account administrator has turned off that functionality. Once you start making and receiving calls, your call history will begin to populate. You can filter the information shown at the top to see all history, missed calls, and recorded calls. You can also filter calls to a specific line that you are assigned. In this example, I can see just the recorded calls for our customer service phone line. For additional options for a particular call, hover over the call and click on the ellipsis icon. The flyout menu provides additional options and information, such as the duration of that specific call. In the voicemail section, you can hover over any voicemail and click the play button to hear the message.
Hey, Morgan.
The voicemail will expand, revealing more information about the call. You will see who called, their phone number or extension, when the call was received, and a transcript of the message. For additional options, click the ellipsis icon. The flyout menu provides other options, such as the ability to mark the message as unread, download the voicemail, or just delete it. Judging by the transcript, I'll go ahead and block this spam call. For many, the lines subsection may be pretty simplistic. Your phone line will appear here, and that might be all that you see. However, if you answer calls on the behalf of another person, are a member of a shared line group, or if you monitor the lines of other team members, those lines will be displayed here. The final section is SMS, where your message history is displayed. To start a new SMS message, click the pencil icon. Enter a phone number or start typing a name to start searching your contacts, and then enter your message. If you have access to multiple lines, you can choose which line you are texting from. Now, there are specific settings related to Zoom Phone in the desktop application. Click on your profile image in the upper right corner, then click on Settings. Along the left-hand menu, click on Phone. Here you can double-check that Zoom.us is the default program for calls. This is a Mac-only setting, so if you are on Windows, you won't see this portion. You can also check or uncheck the box to hide incoming calls while you are in a Zoom meeting. One crucial setting to point out relates to your emergency address. If the emergency address shown doesn't match where you currently are, click on Personal Location or Address and update the information. Now you are ready to answer the call with Zoom Phone.